learners to Krishna Kanta Handicap State Open University. Today we'll be discussing about hotel management and the various implications associated with it. For this, we have with us one of the senior lecturers of Institute of Hotel Management and Catering Technology and Applied Nutrition, Mr. Soumitra Sen. He has been associated with this industry for the last 28 years, so we all can say that he has become an iconic figure of this industry. Welcome, sir. It's a pleasure having you here.
Same here.
Sir, as today's topic, it indicates the concept of hotel management. So, firstly, we would all like to know, what do you mean by hotel management?
Hotel management basically means application of managerial techniques in a professional way, how to run the hospitality industry per se.
Okay. And sir, what are the advantages as well as disadvantages associated with this industry?
So let's first
start with advantages.
Be positive.
Yes.
So advantages, there are many, because this is one of the happening industry in not only in Indian context but in global scenario. And as the trade and commerce is increasing, and as it is truly nowadays been said, globe has become a village and people are traveling wide and far, and therefore they require food and accommodation wherever they are going, for whatever purpose that may be. And that increases the scope and opportunities of this particular field, industry. And therefore, from my past experience, I can say that all our students, even when they are studying in the final years, actually we are running a 3 years degree program. So when they are in the final year, the third year, most of the students, you can say almost 90% of the students are having job. Not only one job, but 4 to 5 jobs in all corporate worlds and what we call chain hotels and other related field activities. So that is the greatest advantage what I can say about this particular industry. And in today's scenario, when unemployment is one of the greatest issue, so this is one of the industry which is giving and career opportunities for the young generation. And before they are graduating, they are actually landing up with very lucrative and challenging jobs. And as you say, the disadvantage, one disadvantage is that still, especially in this part of the country, is the social taboo that is attached with the hotel industry. So we cannot deny the fact, but the things are changing. It is not unlike what it was about 15 or 20 years back. Now the parents are realizing that is a challenging opportunities, and the social taboos are changing. So many young people, especially girls, they are also joining this particular industry. And therefore, this is a very healthy sign we can say about the industry. There's one more disadvantage that can be said is that initial salary is one of the, or the remuneration package that has been offered is little bit low. But things are changing with more and more hotel comings. Competition among the hoteliers is forcing them to increase the packages. So let's hope for the best, and I think within 2 years entire scenario change as far as the packages are concerned.
Another question that has come up, like, what are the specializations courses that the students can take up in hotel management? Or is there a particular one single course, or you can take specializations?
No, they can take specialization, but okay, basically if they are going for a 3 years full-fledged program, okay, in hotel industry you have four core areas. Okay. Those are food production, which includes the cookery and the bakery part, how to cook food, how to bake a cake, all those things. Then we have the food and beverage service, where the food that has been cooked has been, how it is to be served aesthetically, authentically to the guest, as well as a beverage which includes the drinks and all. These are the two core areas, and other two core areas related to the room division, that is the upkeep of the rooms, housekeeping, how to keep the room clean and how to make it ready for the guest coming and occupying the room. And obviously the selling part of the room, that is the front box. Front desk, we call it front office. So these are the four core areas: food production, F&B service, housekeeping, and front office. So these four core areas are already incorporated in the module of the 3 years program. And apart from that, there are some short courses, 1.5 year duration, where, as you ask, specialization can be done depending upon which core area the student aspire to see himself or herself in. So food production is one area, F&B is one area, housekeeping is another area, as well as front office is another area. So four core areas are there. And now also the MSc program have started. If somebody wants to do further studies on this, so MSc in hospitality and hotel administrations are also available. So this other thing, and few, three or four institutes are giving specialization in the third year. That is very few institutes, as on a trial basis they have started. So again, any one of this core area they can choose as a specialization in the third area. But most of the majority, I guess 80% of the students are going for the four core areas, and then in the campus, they are taking the team, which area they want to go for.
The four core areas, you will be studying throughout the three years, and when you enter the job, when you enter the company, then you can take up your own, one thing that you like, that the students like. Okay.
As per their knack, as per their liking.
Okay. And sir, speaking of hotel, I have seen there are small 5-star hotel, 3-star hotel. So what can be the basic classification of a hotel? How can you classify a hotel?
Very good question. So rather technical question.
Technical question, yes.
Actually, we classify hotel in various parameters, like location. That may be a parameter. That is where the located hotel is located. Okay. Now, if it is located in a city, we call it a city hotel. If it is located in suburban area, little outskirt of the city, we call it suburban area. If it is situated on the highways, we call it motel.
Okay.
If it is on a river, we call it flotel, like houseboat of Kashmir.
Yes.
So that is the location area. But most, then again, the size, how many rooms, small hotel, large hotel, very large hotel, medium hotel, like that we classify. Then depending upon the clientele, what type of clientele, whether the tourist, business class, all this. But basically, the most authentic classification depends upon the facility that the hotel is
offering.
So depending upon that, the star category is being done. In India, we have, Government of India recognizes 6 types of category. 1-star, 2-star, 3-star, 4-star, 5-star and 5-star deluxe. So these are the categories. And there is another type of categories that are nowadays being used, that is the heritage hotel category, where the old havelis, which are constructed before 1945 or 35, depending again, different types of heritage classics and all those things are there. So these are basically the way the hotels are categorized. But most commonly, which has been there in the industry, is depending upon the facilities and star classification.
Sir, and as you have mentioned about the specializations, so could you just, you know, give a brief description about front office or food and beverages, what the students do, I mean, during the three-year course and housekeeping as well?
As you said, that this is mostly hands-on and technical course. Okay. So therefore, they have to undergo full-fledged practical training. Like if I say food production. Mm-hmm. So this is basically how to cook food. Not only home food, but international cuisine. So in that way, our curriculum is structured. So in the first year itself, now we have gone for the semester system. So first 2 semesters, they have been exposed to do individual cooking, where the basic art and the science of cooking has been given to them. Then in the second year, they have to go for bulk cooking, because they have to do for, say, cooking for 500 people for a banquet party. So that knowledge, that is a little different from when you are doing for individual or small group. And in the third, it is totally international cuisine, where we are going for the continental cuisines, which includes French cuisine, German cuisines, then Oriental cuisine, Chinese, another Oriental cuisine, Indian cuisine. Mm-hmm. So all this. And Indian cuisines has also been a part of the second year. When they are doing the bulk cooking, the specialization in Indian cooking, different regional cuisine we call it. Different regions of India is covered in the second year.
Like the North Indian food, South Indian food, Eastern food. Okay. And sir, in housekeeping, what do the students basically do?
Basically, housekeeping means the upkeep of the room. That means how to decorate the room, how to clean the room, which obviously includes the cleaning of toilet, the rooms, the bed, everything. Then the interior decoration, the color scheme, all these inputs are given to the students so that when they go to the industry, they are fit enough and confident enough to meet to the challenges. Not only keeping the room up to date as far as cleanliness, hygiene is concerned, but also to change the decor as per the trend and the tradition and the fashion of the day.
And in the front office?
Front office basically means receiving of the guest. That means right from the guest when they are coming in and registering themselves, which we call technically check-in, till check-out, settling of bill. The entire activity of the hotel is, that means welcoming of the guest, till settling of the guest bill, all these activities, and throughout the guest stay, they are the only one who are interacting with the guest. For any needs of the guest, they are the person. So we are training up this guest, as well as we are training up how to handle the guest. So that is another plus things that
very
gives
positive.
Us confidence and positiveness to the students to handle various types of situations. Various types of situations may arise. So those are the things which is being done.
Another topic was that of, as we have discussed right now, food and beverages. So I have heard there are two terms, like food and beverages service and food and beverages production. So what is the basic difference between them?
Okay. See, both are related with food and beverage.
Yes.
So somebody have to prepare the food. So that is the food and beverage production.
Okay.
That means cooking part, which includes cooking, baking. Okay. That means production of food. Making the food ready for consumption of the guest.
Okay.
That is food production. Mm-hmm. And after the food is prepared, the food is to be consumed.
Mm-hmm.
That means food should reach from the kitchen to the table of the guest.
Okay.
So this delivery from the kitchen to the table of the guest is being done by the food and beverage service. That means the restaurant service, the banquet service,
okay,
even the bar service,
okay,
these are the food and beverage
service,
where the drinks are prepared and then it is served to the guest. So that is the food and beverage service.
Okay. Sir, suppose if a student, he or she is not interested to join a hotel after passing out 3-year course, or after doing their hotel management, he is not interested, then what are the various options for that student, for that kind of student?
Very good question, because this is one aspect where the students generally faces at the conclusion of their third year,
okay,
the sixth semester. As I said, that most of the students are landing up with jobs, basically in the hotels or hotel related other activities like motels, resorts and all those things. But there are other career options also. Like one of the career options is further studies, which I have already mentioned, MSc.
Yes.
And also many students of us are going for the MBAs.
Okay.
Because now they have been trained up.
Yes.
They know guest handling. So MBA especially with the specialization of sales and marketing and that of HR, human resource, is a huge demand where the basic graduations they are doing with hotel management.
Okay.
Because this type of thing, the corporate world is finding that they are very suitable for that. So there is a huge demand for it. So many students are opting nowadays for that MBA also. And then there are other options like in airlines.
Okay. Aviation industry
also.
Okay.
Like flight purses, air hostess, even the ground staffs.
Okay.
Many you will find having the hotel management background. Even these aviation academies, they have a hotel management module incorporated in their thing.
Okay.
So that is another aspect. Then the railway caterings, IRCTC.
Right.
So this is a very good option.
Mm-hmm.
Then cruise liners,
okay,
like Star Cruises and all. So there again, the accommodation and all the basic hospitality needs are there. So obviously the hospitality graduates have huge demands over there.
Okay.
And then we are having certain software packages, because now, as you know, the hotel is also going through the software phase. We call it PMS, Property Management System.
Okay.
So that is one aspect, because those hotel management graduates, they know the nitty-gritty of it. Then their inputs are required by the software engineers to develop the software. So there is a huge demand for that. And not only that, after the software has been developed, that is to be trained to the hotel staff, the end user.
Yes.
So who are going to do?
Okay.
So there is a huge scope for them over there. And last but not the least, like me, faculty positions.
Okay.
They can also be, there are so many institutes coming up.
Yes.
And there's a huge demand for faculty.
Okay.
So with this, they have all these options.
Yes. And sir, as you have said, that hotel industry has gained so much momentum during the last decade. So according to me, or according to some students, still there is a taboo among the people that, you know, one should not join hotel management. So do you think that hotel management has really gained much momentum during the last decade?
I can quote the statistics.
Okay.
To justify my point. Mm. When I graduated, it's way back in 83. That time there was only 4 institute of hotel management under central government in the 4 major metros.
That's all over India?
All over
okay,
India.
Okay, okay.
And now there are 50 institutes.
50.
Out of that, 21 are central government institutes, 14 are state government institutes,
okay,
and rest are private institute affiliated to the National Council, the nodal agency of the central government, which is controlling the hotel management. I'm talking about only the central government institutes.
Okay.
Apart from that, there's mushroom growth of hotel management institute on and off, and you are seeing in the paper advertisement.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Now that itself is a statistical proof that many, many students are
opting for this
particular
course.
But one thing, all said and done, one thing still remains, as I said, already mentioned in our previous discussion, that there's still certain social taboos attached to it.
Yes.
People's mentality, especially the parents, they are a little bit apprehensive of their words joining or the children joining, kids joining this particular industry.
Yes.
But as I said, now the things are changing. And with all this internet and the TVs coming inside the bedroom, people are now realizing that this is not so bad as it is. And you can say, wherever you go, this type of problems are there.
Okay.
Everything
yes,
has a
every course has some advantage and some disadvantage. Definitely.
Nothing is foolproof under the
yes, course. Definitely. And so, sir, the last question that remains with me is that what is the admission procedure? That will be helpful for the learners as well.
As I said, I'm just going to tell you the admission procedure in the government institutes.
Okay. Yes.
Private institutes, they have their own admission procedures. They generally have the advertisement, then they have this placement
interviews
and all
yes,
those
sir.
Things. Then this educational edu fairs and all.
Mm-hmm.
So those parts are there. By that process, they are doing it. In the case of government, we have this joint entrance examination, JEE.
Okay.
This has generally been advertised at the last part of the month of December
okay.
on all leading newspapers.
Okay.
Plus, they have their own website, nchncity.org, National Council for Hotel Management and Catering Technology.org.
nchncity.org. Okay.
So, the advertisement is also there.
Okay.
And after that, there will be an examination, which is generally held in the month of April.
Okay.
Middle of April.
Okay.
So that is a joint entrance examination. This is more or less reasoning and little bit of English like that.
Okay.
Not a very tough one as so as to say. And after that All India selection, the merit list has been prepared.
Okay.
And then on online counseling is there. There are a few centers of online counseling where the students has to go. And as per their ranking and their merit list, they can choose the institute out of the 50 institutes.
Okay, sir. There are 50 institutions.
50 institutes.
For which the entrance test is being held.
Okay. And apart from that, for the Northeast students, especially for the students of Assam, we have quota only in IHM Guwahati, which is under Directorate of Tourism.
Okay.
Government of Assam.
Okay.
Which they have the office in the near the Reserve Bank of India, Station Road.
Okay.
So they advertise in the paper, leading paper,
okay.
And that is on the, they have, I think the cutoff marks is 50% in their high secondary plus 2 exam, and then there will be an interview only and they will get selected. If they miss the joint entrance bus, for some reasons or other,
okay.
Either they didn't appear, miss the day, or they are not successful, still they have another chance to join this hotel management stream through this quota of Assam. Similarly, other North East states also have the quota.
Okay. So that's a boon for the for the Assam government students. Okay. So thank you so much, sir. I personally have gained much from this discussion, and I'm sure that our learners have quite benefited a lot from the discussion. So thank you so much, sir, for sharing your thoughts and giving us your valuable time and input. Thank you.
Pleasure
sir.
Is all mine. Thank you.